morning. Welcome to Wednesday night Bible study. We are so, so glad that you are joining us tonight with everything else you have going on in your life. I am Sarah Jane. I am the pastor at New Dublin Presbyterian Church.
And my name is Don Hanchu. I'm one of the pastors at Dublin United Methodist Church, and we're actually in Dublin United Methodist Church today.
We are. Grateful to be hosted.
Well, you had some furnace issues.
Oh, man, there's a lot going on in New Dublin today.
Yeah, you got all kinds of stuff going on. So, yeah, super glad to have some time together with you here together.
Today, we are going to be reading Psalm 77. So, if you're using a physical Bible, if you crack open basically to the middle of your Bible, you'll find the book of Psalms. And because it's the whole psalm, it's not a terribly long psalm, but we try to keep these videos short. So go ahead, pause the video and read it through, and then come back and Don will pray for us.
Sure. So let's pray. God, as we are on this journey together of Lent that brings us to the cross, help us see ways to reflect, repent, to live our life in such a way that others would know in whom we believe and whom we trust, even when things are hard. Guide our time now of study and reflection, and we just give you praise. Amen.
Amen. And things are hard right now. They've been hard for a year.
Yeah.
For the whole world, and maybe in your life, hard for longer than that. And this is really a psalm for when life is hard. You can see right off the bat, the person who wrote the psalm is not shy about telling us how bad things are. We get, a solid 6 verses purely dedicated to how upset this person is. And then we come, I think, to the heart of the question for the person who wrote the psalm, and a lot of times the heart of the question for us when we're suffering, which is, has God decided he hates me? The Bible says that God is faithful forever, but maybe God has changed his mind. Which is, it's putting it a little bit facetiously, but I think we all understand.
Well, when you're in the bottom of the bucket, the deepest part of the valley, you think everybody's picking on you, and like God for surely is mm-hmm. picking on you, we've all been there, and you may be there now. So it seems silly, but it's also something we say to ourselves in our hearts and heads. Like, nobody cares about me, not even God.
Mm-hmm. God is punishing me. God hates me.
Yeah.
This is the way it's going to be. And even if you know in your head that this is not the way it's going to be forever, it's really hard to tell your heart that when you're in the middle of the storm.
Oh, gosh, yeah. I can tell you a story that... I needed somebody to remind me of some things. A number of years ago, I was out west in Seattle with some friends and family, and was riding a mountain bike, having a blast of a weekend. And then the weekend ended with me having a wreck and hitting my head hard enough and knocked me out cold for like 45 minutes, which was a pretty significant, closed head injury. Which meant that I had all those other characteristics, where amnesia was mostly the biggest thing, and actually kind of funny, because I don't really remember the trip other than the pictures that the people showed me. So when we see those pictures, or what they would do after that, they would pull out the pictures after they were developed. Back in the day, you had to develop pictures. They said, yeah, I remember doing this. And I'm like, no, but it sure looks like I was having a good time. So it was helpful for me to go back through those pictures and say, oh, that's what we did. That was a good time, as opposed to not remembering anything or only remembering just the pain of the concussion.
And that's often when we are going through, the life equivalent of a bike wreck. We often do experience that kind of, where all we can see is the negative. And we can't remember, or even if we remember, we don't get the full experience of the good things. And that's how... you had people to remind you of what happened. That's basically what happens in this psalm. He remembers what God has done in the past, especially we have highlighted here the Exodus in this kind of poetic way, which is the example above all for the psalm writer of God's continual faithfulness. And that's really kind of the takeaway of this psalm. He doesn't end with, and my life is great now, right? there's no indication that anything has gotten better for the psalm writer, except that he ends on an affirmation that even if, you know, life is terrible right now, God continues to be faithful. And a lot of times when you are in Sunday school or wherever, and somebody introduces the idea that God never changes, which is one of the ancient affirmations about God, God never changes, it can seem kind of hard or cold, or like God doesn't care enough to be affected by what's going on in our lives. But it's when you're in a situation, not when you're in a classroom or in your Sunday school class or when everything's basically fine, that's not when you need the affirmation that God never changes. You need it when you're in this kind of situation where everything is terrible. And then you need the reminder that the God who was faithful in the Exodus, was faithful in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, has been faithful in your life in the past. That's the same God who hasn't changed, that's going to continue to be faithful to you in your present and in your future.
Amen.
So that's your takeaway. Whatever's going on in your life, God is there with you and is going to be faithful to you through it. And if you need somebody to remind you, give us a call.
I'd be glad to do that. I'll close this in prayer. God, thank you for this day. And we pray for each individual right now who's struggling in this difficult journey that they have. Maybe it's at work. Maybe it's at home. Maybe it's with a neighbor. Maybe it's at the realization of just things that are not going to go back to the way they were now that we're living toward a post-COVID life. God, in whatever those difficult situations, help us not just see the negative. Help us be reminded of the stories of the good of how you've been with us as well. Lord, I pray that our community, faith community, our larger community here in Dublin and Pulaski, that we would be able to lift you up so that we can remember the good stories and live into that kind of future. We give you praise for tonight. In the name of your son, we pray. All God's people said, amen.
Amen.
We'll see you next week. And we'll be looking at a passage and talking a little bit about our kind of how we struggle with making right choices, but how God can really help us find a better way to make those choices. We'll see you then.
Take care.